Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Previously, I mentioned forgiveness and tawbah, repentance from sins. And now I'd like to mention how merciful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is and how ready He is to forgive our sins. Now, with regards to the sins we mentioned last week, that inna Allah la yaghfiru an yushraka bih wa yaghfiru ma duna dhalika liman yasha. Allah would not forgive shirk if a person dies on shirk, and He will forgive anything besides that. Now, no matter how great the sin is, and there's a beautiful hadith in Tirmidhi in which Anas bin Malik radiallahu an says, "Sami'tu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul," I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, "Qala Allah tabarak wa ta'ala," this is a hadith of Qudsi, that Allah says, "Yabn Adam, innaka ma da'awtani wa rajawtani ghafartu laka ala ma kana fik wa la ubali," that, "Oh son of Adam, oh insan, you will keep, as long as you keep seeking me and you have hope from me, ghafartu laka ala ma kana fik, I will forgive you for whatever you commit, for the mistakes, the sins that you commit, wa la ubali, and I do not care." These are the words, wa la ubali, I do not care, the sins that you commit, I'll forgive. Yabn Adam, لو بلغت ذنوبك عنان السماء, O son of Adam, if your sins reach the heights of the sky, ثم استغفرتني, then you seek forgiveness from me, غفرت لك ولا أبالي, I will forgive you and I do not care. The sins, what is mentioned here, reach the heights of the sky. Now none of us have committed such an amount of sins where the earth would be full and it would reach the heights of the sky. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, even if it's that much, I would forgive and I would not care. This is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how much He is ready and willing to forgive a person. It's just the lack is on our part, where we don't turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek forgiveness. Further, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Hadith al-Qudsi, Yabna Adam, innaka law atayta bikurabi al-ardi, innaka law ataytani bikurabi al-ardi khataya, thumma laqitani, la tushrik bi shay'a. لَأَتَيْتُكَ بِقُرَابِهَا مَغْفِرَةً, Oh son of Adam, if you come to me with an earth full of sins, and then you meet me in such a state where you do not commit shirk, again shirk is mentioned here, you meet me in such a state where you do not commit shirk, لَأَتَيْتُكَ, then I will come to you with an earth full of مغفرة, with an earth full of forgiveness. So this is the hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. If we are sincere and we keep trying to do the right things to save ourselves from sin and then repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with forgiveness, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yes, we all know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, His anger, His wrath is very dangerous and we need to save ourselves from that, but His rahmah, His mercy overpowers that. And this hadith, mutafaq alayh, another hadith which is mutafaq alayh, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, mentioned that lama khalaqallahu al-khalq, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the creation, it was written in the book, فَهُوَ عِنْدَهُ فَوْقَ الْعَرْشِ, and that is with Him above the arsh, which is the Lawh al-Mahfuz. إِنَّ رَحْمَتِي تَغْلِبُ غَضَبِي, that my rahma, my mercy, it overpowers and it overshadows my anger. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry, and we need to save ourselves from His wrath as well, but He is so merciful. And especially in this month, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His mercy increases, the doors of Jannah are open, the doors of hellfire are closed. This is a time where we need to seek His forgiveness, gain the closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and attain Jannah through our a'mal and through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's pleasure. May Allah give us the ability to do so. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.